Today is May 26th. May the Lord of Peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. Take a moment and quiet yourself. Take a deep breath. Welcome God's presence and say, "Come, Holy Spirit." Today's reading is from Romans chapter 8.
For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. The Spirit you received does not make you slaves so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you received brought about your adoption to sonship. And by him we cry, "Abba, Father." The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs, heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ. If indeed we share in his sufferings, in order that he may also share in his glory.
Our prayers this week have all considered the astonishing and overwhelming nature of the love of God. That his love compelled him to draw near, to rescue, and to redeem. Today, the passage makes that love personal. Abba, the Hebrew word for father, has the intimate feel of our daddy. The passage calls us children and heirs, not outsiders or onlookers, but family. Do you feel that spiritually connected to God right now? Most of us don't get to feel childlike very often. There's too much adulting to do, too many responsibilities, and too much overwhelm. As you listen again, can you get in touch with any interior desire you might have to become childlike? To not be burdened by so much need? Or so much responsibility.
For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. The Spirit you received does not make you slaves so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you received brought about your adoption to sonship. And by him we cry, "Abba, Father." The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs, heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ. If indeed we share in his sufferings, in order that he may also share in his glory.
When my daughter was very young, she started all her prayers with the phrase, "Please, Jesus." And then she'd just say all the things that were on her mind. Please, Jesus, she'd pray, Grandmom and Papa. Please, Jesus, my friends. Please, Jesus, all those we love. As we end our time of prayer, can you come to God with a childlike, please, Jesus, sort of prayer? What do you need? What do you want? What do you hope for? Pray with your mind turned to the love of God for you. Lord God, Almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought me in safety to this new day. Preserve me with your mighty power, that I may not fall into sin, nor be overcome by adversity. And in all I do, direct me to the fulfilling of your purpose. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
May our praise fill your ears. May our cries touch your heart.